I Can you tell me, in one word, what would be the biggest challenge for a hydro motion here?
Good question. I think it's probably time. Time kind of defines everything we do. We don't have years to wait for cleaner solutions. The world is changing too fast. As a team, we start from zero every year, building a hydrogen-powered boat completely from scratch. When designing, we always innovate and push the boundaries of what is possible. But time drives us to iterate quickly, meaning we have to optimize the communication between the departments. I think this is the most visible in the hull and body department, as they need to start designing immediately and have a design finished within 8 weeks.
It starts in a general concept phase with the whole team.
We had some ideas about what we at least want to have in our boat.
So basically, I look at what shape the boat has had in the previous years, what worked well, what didn't really work well, and then we basically combine all the things that worked very well, put them in the new boat, and then all the things that didn't really work well, we left them out. After the outside was done, we went to the inside of the boat.
I started with finding out all the parts that had to go into the side of the boat, also the mass of them, the size of them, and seeing if they would fit in the design that Minke was making. Placing bulkheads at certain locations and placing stiffeners to hold up certain parts inside of the boat that are heavy.
I think it's we are sort of the skeleton of the boat, I would say. So all the structural integrity basically comes from us. We accommodate all the organs of the boat, so the tanks and the fuel cell, those things really need to be in there, they need to be well protected, and the whole thing needs to come together as a full structure, so that's what we're mostly working on.
Hull and body has interfaced with everyone, so they have to kind of come to a middle in case of like sizing of components inside the boat, because we want to make it as efficient as possible and as light as possible, but there are some components that you can't make lighter, so then there's a compromise there. This year we decided to have a pie foil in the front because we want to do banking turns, which is a huge innovation in the foils. Banking turns are when the boat doesn't just yaw in this direction, but also turns a bit like banks, like an airplane to turn, which minimizes the steering you need and generally is more efficient. The foils are essentially airplane wings. It works with the same exact principles, and even the foils we use are designed for jets. And also it's like an airplane. The airplane doesn't land just like, or take off like flat. There are some angles involved.
We have like a flying boat, right? And we have sensors that we need to read, like for the internal measurement unit, for the direction of the boat. There's also the height of the boat if we're marrying with an ultrasonic, with the sound. And then the people from Embedded make all the flaps and wings pitch in the right way so the boat doesn't fall and fly straight over the water. I first started off with looking at the system of last year. It was a bit of a maze to discover how they did it last year, what kind of sensors do they have, the data sheets. I'm responsible for the monitoring of the hydrogen and also like the sensors. I made a little document for myself to get an overview of the previous system. And based on that, I decided I looked into what I need in my PCB. And I started developing the first PCB for the hydrogen. Hydrogen, of course, is a really good energy carrier. That's why we built a boat around it. But at the same time, it's also, in a sense, not as stable as, for example, just a normal battery or just gasoline. You cannot just store it in a tank and call it a day. For like your car, you can just fill it up with gas, probably leave it for a week and then just start it up. For hydrogen, that's not the same because we store it in a tank, and there's also hydrogen buildup, so the liquid turns into gas. And there are all systems that need to be monitored, like the pressure, the temperature, stuff like that. I definitely feel like it's, in a way, a big responsibility because the goal for this year is to sail on liquid hydrogen. The liquid hydrogen PC should really work, so I think I have to manage my time really good with also the other tests that I have during the week. So I think time is my biggest battle, for sure.
In the beginning, you really don't know a lot about the system, so you need to do a lot of research. All of us have like a bit of a background in like mechanical studies or electrical studies. So we know quite a bit already, but not like in this practical way how we are implementing it now. The main problem is still getting the logistics right of the liquid hydrogen. There are only like 3 places in Europe where they produce it, and if you want to get it transported, most companies only do it in 1 to 3 tons of hydrogen, while we only use 8 kilograms. 8 kilos is enough to go like 3.5 hours at full speed, full power. So you can go very, very far with 8 kilos in our boat. Hydrogen inside of tanks, inside of a system, is very safe because everything is rated for pressures way, way above what we are running it at. And all of the connections are checked, so really it cannot really leak. Most of the parts are just off the shelf. So we'll start with testing fuel cell, then we will build the full gas system, and after that we will build the full liquid system. After everything works and is tested how we want it to work, then we combine them into one big system and then put it inside of the boat and seal.
I think in the end we're going to be very proud of our design. I'm already proud of it. I worked more than 8 weeks non-stop of building this boat, and it's a little bit my baby now. And I think seeing it come to life eventually will be a very nice moment. And I think we as a team, but also I think the two of us together, can be very proud.
I think everybody would be really proud of us once it comes to life and you see that what you have built, and it's actually in front of you, and it's quite a boat. Like, now you're seeing it on your little laptop screen, but then it's there in real life. I'm really looking forward to that, and I think that will be a moment really say, like, yeah, we have designed it, and yeah, it makes you proud.
I can be proud. I'm very confident that it will work.
I'm proud of it, yes.